Okay, di ISC, before we continue, any of you have actually attended courses touch on personality profiling on this? There's a few, yeah, when it comes to personality profiling. We have the ISC, we have DOPE or DOPE, yeah. And of course, Myers-Briggs, we have done it yesterday. So the ISC, have any of you been introduced of or done or assessment on the ISC before? Tak ada ya. Kalau tak ada, tak apa. Kalau yang pernah jawab assessment pasal this on this the ISC, so ini adalah refresh, macam recap lah, refresher untuk anda. Kepada siapa yang belum, ini adalah pertama kali buat anda, maka it will be very interesting for you. Because it will share more about why do you talk in a certain way, why do you get information in a certain way, and how, why do people talk to you in that manner. Itu yang kita akan touch on the ISC, ya, personality profiling ni. Before kita go further, so let's get to know more about us. Kita nak buat assessment. Okay, I'm going to share with you, share screen with you the assessment, ya. Again, yes. Okay, if you can see, ada part 1, 2, 3 and 4, betul? Betul, ya?
Okay.
Okay, dalam part 1, okay, dalam setiap part, kita ada list, ya, sebanyak 20 list of your traits. Traits untuk dalam setiap part tu, ya. Okay, part 1 stands for dominant, part 2 stands for influencer, part 3 is steady, and the last one, part 4 is compliant, ya. Jadi what we need you to do untuk setiap part tu, ada part 1, 2, 3 dan 4, tick, ya. Okay, kita bagi contoh kat sini, can we just show you some sample, ya. Okay, let's say part 1 tu, saya pun tandalah saya very okay, very competitive, very driver, tu semua saya lah, ya. Okay, so at the end of that, saya total lah, score, and then berapa tu score saya? 9. So dalam part 1, score saya adalah 9. Score saya adalah 9, ya. Kalau semua dalam, katakan dalam each, dalam traits in all part tu, that is all you, you boleh tanda semua, tak ada masalah. Okay, dan kalau tak ada, tak apa, tak payah tanda. Tidak perlu memaksa diri memilih traits tu kalau itu bukan anda, ya. Kalau ada macam trainer suruh isi, tapi satu pun tak ada saya, macam mana? Tak apa, tak payah tanda. Kalau itu adalah you, tanda, ya. So dia mesti secara spontan. When you nampak traits tu, let's say part 1 tadi, okay, competitive, that's you. Bila you nampak tu, that's you, you macam, ah, I memang competitive, terus tanda, tick that box, eh. Dan sama juga untuk setiap part-part yang lain. So please score. Nanti kalau anda nampak, ya, di bawah tu, for each part tu ada total, kan, betul, ada tanda macam bintang. That is where you need to total up the score for each part, ya. And after that, we will explore further what is your personality. Okay, before we analyze each and every scoring, let us just share with you in general, ya. In general, personality, ya. What is D, what is I, what is S, and what is C. Okay, are you guys ready? If you are ready, say ready.
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 Okay.
Ready.
Okay, have ready. Fun knowing yourself more, ya. Okay, kalau anda D, okay, D actually stands for dominant, ya. Sinonim dengan nama dia sekali, bila anda dengar D tu, oh, dominant, mesti dia nak dominate orang. Bukan macam tu, ya. Those that have a very high D, they are decision maker. Alright, they like to lead the way. They like things fast. They focus on result, bottom line, straight to the point. Yeah, dia tak suka buang masa. So that is D. And of course, D like to take risk. Dia suka ambil risk. Okay. And most of the time, whoever has a very high D, dia very extrovert lah. Dia suka ke hadapan. Jangan letak dia belakang tabir. Dia tak suka. So kalau ada pementasan, siapa yang D ni, dia suka anda letak dia bawah spotlight. Lagi panas, lagi bagus. Jangan letak dia belakang langsir ataupun dia jadi sound engineer saja, dia tak nak. They want people to see them. They want people to see the world to see them. That is D. Yeah? But the most important thing, kalau D ni focus on solution, they want result. And they want things fast. Itu cerita dia. Dan dia tak suka you melalut-lalut. You have to be, you have to have framework tu dah kena ada. Kalau you jumpa dengan dia kan, siapa yang D ni dia nak, you dah ada other path, how you going to get what you want. Itu D, eh. Alright. So nanti kita akan connectkan, eh. Alright, now part 2. Part 2 is influencer. Sit together with me, my friend. Part 2, I is
influencer.
Influencer. Alright, when you hear the word influencer, oh nak influence orang lah tu. Okay. Influencer ni, dia ada similarities dengan D. They like risk. Dia suka risiko. Again, I whoever has a very high eye, eye ni dia mesti kena letak dia kat depan juga. Kena orang nampak dia, kena orang notice dia, dia suka acknowledgement. And best part about I ni, they are very good in telling stories, they are very good in convincing people, dia memang pandai. Sampai kan kalau dia bercerita, long, long, once upon a time, long, long time ago, far, far away kingdom. Far, far away kingdom kan, kalau dia bercerita kan, the time will stay still. And you boleh menangis kalau dengar orang influencer ni cerita, ya. That is influencer. They like that appreciation. They like to be recognized. Itu cerita dia, siapa influencer. So, siapa yang high, very high juga, tak boleh letak mereka di belakang tabir. Kena depan. Depan spotlight juga. They like to take risk. And they like to talk. They like to... Dia bukan suka sangat socialize tau. Tapi dia suka people to be around them. To see their existence. That they are different. They will find ways to attract people. Ini dia, I. So, these two high risk taker. Let's continue, ya. Part 3. Part 3 adalah... S stands for steady. So steady, whoever is steady, you are very, you are people oriented. Okay, you tak suka work alone. You kena dalam group. You suka ketenangan. And you tak suka sakit-sakit kepala. Itu cerita dia. So you want whatever you want to do kan, dia mesti ada business process dia. Maknanya you need to be told what need to be done. Jangan kasi you pening kepala. That is S. Eh? You just tell them what to do. This is the method. This is what we want you to dibuat. Itu dia orang S. And orang S ni, dia tak suka high risk. Things which is norm, yang biasa, kebiasaan, they love it. When you ask them to change or do something new, dia tak berapa suka. And most of the time, dia memang tak suka. Kalau dia dah biasa ambil route A, tiba-tiba you nak suruh dia ambil route B, dia macam, dia pening sikit. Yeah? So, those yang steady, they like to work in a group. They are very calm. Yeah? They don't like to stress up themselves. And when you want them to do something, you just kena bagi method pada dia A to Z. You jangan suruh dia macam, you rasa macam mana? What is your solution? And dia kena tenang macam I cerita tadi. So, this is steady. Yeah? Those yang steady. Nanti I cerita lagi.
Sorry, can I ask?
Yeah.
High risk meaning putting themselves into a high risk situations, is it?
Okay, risk ni macam ni maksud saya, ya Amira. They like to take risk. Maknanya if you give any new ideas which is not being done before pun, if they can see that ideas tu can give them the result that they want, they will just go for it. Sama dengan yang I. Tapi kalau S contohnya, dia tak nak. Dia kena ini macam tak pernah buat lah. Saya tak berapa comfortable. So tu jenis orang steady, ya. Eh? They like
to faham.
Jelas, eh. Ini memang very people oriented ni, steady ni. Dia tak boleh, you jangan suruh dia kerja seorang, and of course dia tak suka risk, dan dia tak juga tak suka di bawah spotlight lah sebab dia suka ketenangan kan. So normally siapa yang steady ni kalau ada pementasan ke apa ke, jangan suruh dia jadi pelakon watak utama. Suruh dia jaga penataan cahaya, jaga props, belakang tabir, they are fine. They don't like the attention goes to them, they stress. They need that people touch, You kena talk to them first, then they can make decision, yeah? Nanti saya akan move further. One at a time, eh?
Thank you very much.
You're most welcome. That's steady. And then last but not least, is what, my friend? C, compliant, yeah? Say it together with me, compliant.
Compliant.
Dengar perkataan compliant ni sendiri pun, oh, they always compliant. Senang. Compliant, they are very structured. They kena follow the rules. Kena follow SOP. They are very disciplined. Dia nak semua ikut framework. Kena organ, that's them basically. And they also tak suka risk. Dia kena, kena follow, mesti follow the rules betul-betul. Kalau tidak, dia tak nak buat. So far so good. Ini orang compliant, ya? That is in a nutshell their character. But then again, compliant pun, they don't really like to work with people lah. Dia nak belakang tabir. Tapi because they just, everything needs to follow the rules, eh? Okay, now let me just share with you in different department kat mana ya, selalu ada ni, eh? So D is normally head of department, your GM ke, your senior manager, your directors. They need to have this D, so they can lead you the way. They know what they want, they know how to get it, they know how to guide you, and they know where to get the resources. So kalau you are the head, tak kisah department mana, you kena ada D. Okay, kalau you punya boss ataupun you punya superior atau you punya team tak ada D dan you pun tak ada D, habis. It's very challenging for you to move on. It's very challenging for you to achieve the targets that is given to you. Yeah. So D, kalau you have to lead someone, actually everybody have to have D lah, so that you can get the result that you need to get. Itu dia cerita dia. Tapi nanti kita tengok scoring, eh. Having too much D ni satu je. When you have a very high D, you will lack of sensitivity. Maknanya, you tak kisah dah perasaan orang, you tak kisah orang susah ke tak, as long as you get the result. Okay, so now, the question is, yeah, bila you tahu, you boleh identify orang tu macam mana, eh? Kalau boss you, jenis yang bila you jumpa dia, dia akan, okay, tell me the result, tell how it's going on, tell me the progress, itu maknanya D dia very high, eh. So kalau you kena selalu kena marah dengan boss, yang bila you cerita dengan boss you, I have some situation lah boss. Okay, ayat yang paling best kali, I have a problem jumpa boss you. So kalau boss you D very high, add on please, ya, yeah, Halisa.
Sure.
Kalau dia very high, dia akan tanya tau. So, do you have any suggestion? Have you come up with few solution how to overcome the challenges that you face? So kalau you cakap tak ada, memang you kena marah. You get up from my room and then think about it. Once things are good, come and see me how we can approach this thing together. Itu D, eh. Time is very precious. Sebab dia bottom line. So especially siapa dalam sales, marketing, ni memang kena lagi high lah. Okay. Alright. So far so good? Okay. So now you know, kadang-kadang kita tak faham kenapa kena marah dengan boss. Your boss D is very high. And then you datang lenggang-lenggang kangkung je. And it doesn't help kalau you pula I very very high. Move on. I ni selalunya bagus kalau ada dalam department, corporate com. Yeah, corporate com is of course dia ada PR kat situ, crisis management team, ya. Yeah. Your legal pun kalau ada I pun bagus juga, so they can talk in the right manner. Sales. Your ambassador. If you in a department where you have to talk, to present, to convince people, I ni penting. Cuma kalau seseorang tu I dia sangat tinggi kan, dia akan bercakap tak berhenti tau. Saya pernah ada tau boss I. Dan saya pula D is very high. So saya bawa banyak file dengan proposal untuk dapatkan approval daripada boss saya. So then my boss is I very high. And then my boss talk kan. I know my son, and we went to Disneyland, and then habis keluar daripada bilik dia tu, saya bawa file kosong je, tak ada tantangan lagi. Tu saya stress, but D saya high. I want the result. Okay? Ada, pernah jumpa ni, I very high ni, dia tak tentu, tapi kebanyakan dia dalam sales and marketing, corporate call memang banyak ni, ya. Yeah? Sebab dia ada skill to talk to that can like make you listen to them. It's just that they are not structured. They are everywhere. And then they don't take care of the time. So kalau you nak result, cerita je. Ah, kita buat macam ni. Gitu-gitu, gini-gini. Pernah dengar orang cakap macam tu? I always confused when people say that, kita, you tahulah, gitu-gitu. Gitu-gitu tu apa? Atau gini-gini. Pernah tak cakap dengan orang? But I always say, what do you mean by gitu-gitu and gini-gini? Can you please be detailed? Because nanti kan? Tell me what is gitu-gitu and gini-gini. Somebody jump off the window. Somebody climb up the tree ke? Macam mana? You kena cerita dengan I. So influencer ni dia pandai berita. But they don't take care of the time. They are everywhere. So if you are structured, tak masuk compliant ni lagi kan? Pening cakap dengan I ni. So lagi satu I ni, dia suka, because dia suka attract attention kan? Dia suka nak berpakaian cantik selalu. Because they want to be noticed. But we need them, eh? Please do not put in mind that ini lebih bagus daripada ni. We need all of this personality at a certain time. Okay? That is I. So, any questions so far on D and I? Tiada, ya? Alright, let's continue. S. S ni. S, eh? Nanti kita tengok scoring masing-masing, eh? S ni, dia S ni sangat mudah, because dia people people kind of person, ya. Again, they need people touch when you want to deal with them. But it's just that you always, they are so concerned about what people think of them, kan? About people feelings, a bit slow lah things are going to move, ya. Sebab dia akan rasa, you rasa macam mana tu lah, you sedih buat benda ni, dan benda nak gerak susah. Dan yang paling steady ni banyak dalam department IT, admin, yang just follow the procedures to do the task. Jangan suruh dia fikir banyak. Sebab bila bagi new task, dia akan macam confused kat situ. That is steady. Let me give you example steady. Kalau depends, if your steady is the only one is high, your character, you should be like this. Tapi contoh, sila lihat, sila tengok kat luar tu, kain, ada kain tak berjemur? So kalau siapa steady dia memang very high. Steady dia je yang very high. Dia memang literally tengok kat luar tu ada kain berjemur. Ya, ada kain berjemur. At that point of time, masa you minta siapa yang S very high ni, bila tengok kain tu, bukan saja tengok kain sebenarnya. Kalau hari hujan, sila angkatlah kain tu. Betul? Dah angkat kain tu, letaklah dalam bakul. Bakul dekat tempat letak pakaian supaya nanti boleh lipat. Tapi kalau steady dia very high, dia akan tengok je baju tu kat luar. Ada. And then you tanya, hujan, kenapa tak angkat? Semua tengok je, tak semua angkat. Dia tengok je lah. Tu cerita dia. Dia kena A to Z, you have to tell them. So, if you want them to do things that you think they should do, you kena okay, tengok kain kat luar tu ada ke tak. Kalau hari hujan, silangkat. Kalau dah kering, silangkat. Lepas tu, angkat baju-baju tu semua. Kalau dah kering, kalau hujan kan angkat, letak dalam bakul biru, merah, kuning dan hijau ni, ya. Okay. Dah letak ni baju pakai rumah dalam warna bakul merah. Baju pergi kerja dalam bakul warna biru. Baju-baju kecil, baju-baju dalam dalam bakul warna hijau. Baju yang senak buang letak dalam bakul kuning. Bagi tahu macam tu. Lepas tu duduk kat situ, lipat. Lipat, yang ini lipat. Dah tu masuk siap-siap dalam lemari. A, B, C. Yang dah tak nak tu letak dalam plastik. Kita sedekahkanlah kat rumah bakti. Dia macam tu. Dah siap semua, duduk, jangan pergi mana-mana. Then they follow. But it's a bit tiring lah. Jelas? Tu dia, S. Kalau S you yang tinggi. However, kalau you ada other scoring lain, it will enhance you. Tapi ini pun perlu juga. Kalau tidak, kalau tak ada S ni, in our personality, kita stress. Asyik nak result aja. Kenalah, chill juga. Betul? Once a while, have coffee. Jangan ganggu kehidupan I. I not relax. Stone kat situ.
Betul, Natasha.
Betul. That is why it's, but then again, when certain profiling, certain traits, yeah, certain profiling is higher than the other, and you are in a profession that require you a certain personality to be higher, nanti kat situ you akan face some challenges, yeah. Sebab tu kita share ni, yeah. Okay, last but not least, steady ni tadi dalam IT, banyak IT, admin, or any department that you just
code je. Procedures.
Follow procedures. Security, kan? Nampak orang senyum. Dah letih, jangan senyum dah. Adik macam tu je dia ikut. Alright, and last but not least, part 4 ni, compliant. You dengar compliant ni pun, you dah tahu. Compliance ada banyak dalam finance, audit, legal, IR. IR is industrial punya regulations. In charge in that department. Finance, ni selalu HR. HR kena ada ni. Nak-nak yang bahagian payroll tu. Okay? So they really follow the rules. So if you're talking to someone, if your boss happen to be yang compliant ni, you memang kena tunjuk kat dia. Dulu kita pernah buat macam ni, budget kita macam ni, ini dia success yang kita pernah buat. So there's no risk. That should be the way. So kena memang kena follow rules. Kalau tak, dia takkan buat. Dia takkan bagi approval. Sebagai contohlah, you nak claim daripada finance, dia dah bagi tahu kena ada receipt. And you tak ada receipt, sampai besok sudah you cerita macam mana pun, you takkan boleh claim juga. Walaupun masa pergi outstation tu, dia pergi dengan you, naik kereta sama dengan you tau. Dia tumpang kereta you lagi. It's just that you terlupa nak minta receipt masa bayar tol tu. Sebab tak cenggol, tak bawa. You bayar by cash, you lupa minta receipt. Bila you nak claim, you cakap, bukan you pergi dengan I ke? Memang betul, I pergi dengan you. Tapi nak claim, you kena ada receipt. Tak boleh, tak ada receipt. Tu cerita dia, compliant ni. And very punctual. Pukul 5, 4.45. Sometimes 4.30 dia dah ada dah. Sama dengan orang dominant juga. Okay, yang steady ni lain. 4.30. 4.30 tu dia baru nak lompat dari tingkap. Okay, itu dia. Beza dia, nampak? 4.30. Okay, kita jumpa ke 4.30. Okay, 4.30. 4.30 tu baru dia lompat tingkap. Nampak, 4.30. Okay. Kalau yang dua ni dia awal. Influencer ni dia 4.30. Ada meeting ni. Tapi tengah cakap lagi 4.30. Dia 4.30. Ada meeting ni. Dia cakap lagi. Itu tak sampai bilik meeting. 4.50 pun sampai.
Sure, that
does not agree.
Mana
ada? Sebab. Kita sebab you ada yang lain juga. It's connected.
One moment.
Nanti kita share. Don't worry.